It's a force, a wild, untamed might.
This video that you saw of a sailor speaking has been going crazy viral ever since Google has given updates about their new video generator, VEO 3. Many of us were speechless when Google launched VEO 2 because the quality of the video was super realistic. But they have gone a level ahead launching VEO 3 and they have done a lot of changes. So let's see what are the improvements that they have given us. So here, as you can see, VEO 3 can generate 4K videos. I don't know if any AI video generator out there can generate 4K output. I guess the maximum is 720p or 1080p. And another thing is it can generate not only audio, but also people speaking dialogues. So it's basically like you are having the video generator added with Lovin Labs AI voice. These are the major updates, and apart from that, it's just the creativity control, more consistency and stuff. So this is the video that we saw earlier, the sailor speaking, and the prompt is super interesting. As you can see, this is the prompt that they have used to generate this. And I was wondering if the audio was auto-generated, the dialogue was auto-generated. But as you can see here, first they have given the prompt medium shot frames of an old sailor. They have given the character. Then they are adding some more characteristics for the particular character, like his eyes, beard, chin. And next, this is going to be the background. And at the end, they have just given the dialogue within double quotes. So he basically speaks this particular dialogue.
It's a force, a wild, untamed might.
So as you saw that, right, he's literally speaking this particular line. So this is basically how the prompting works. And another insane thing that I found is this particular video over here. And this video is about 22 seconds. I'm not exactly sure if this particular video was generated in a single prompt or like a single video generation, or did they club multiple things, but this is the prompt that they have given. So another distinguishing factor is here they have used a particular key called as audio. So you can see this, right? Audio colon, it says owl hooting, badgers, nervous chitters. So by this way, we can distinguish between a single dialogue as well as a background noise. And another cool thing about this video is in the previous sailor's video, it was a single person speaking dialogue. There weren't multiple characters involved in speaking. But in this video, the owl as well as this animal is also speaking.
They left behind a ball today. It bounced higher than I can jump.
What manner of magic is that?
And just look at the audio quality. Like, if you listen to this audio quality closing, you'd literally imagine this is going to be straight out from a Disney movie dubbing. That's how perfect the audio quality is. And apart from that, here they are also having some video samples. Like here they are having a muddy car. Damn, just look at the quality and the sound definition. That looks super stunning. And here are some other examples. And look at this video. Like, this literally looks as if it's right out of a movie. So they have taken the accuracy to an extremely greater level. And not only this, they have also got some new features for VEO 2. The first one is reference powered video. So as you can see, we need to send two images and it's going to combine them into a single video. And they are also having the input image to output video. So earlier we used to provide only the text, I guess, in VEO 2. I don't know if we had the option to convert an image to video, but we are having that now over here. And apart from that, they are also helping us to create the most problematic thing in video generation, which is consistent characters. And they are also having a way to solve this issue. So this is the input character that they have given in an image, and that character is literally everywhere. It's inside underwater, it's in a server room, it's in a candy lollipop thing. And also they're having the camera controls, which is basically like moving the camera, zooming in, zooming out, move left and right. These are available in most of like the video generators out there, but it's coming to VEO 2, which makes it more special and more creative. And next one is the first and last frame. This was actually present in Killing AI. So this will be the first frame and the last frame will be generated from the first frame. So as you can see, right, it will be a stone at first and then you'll be getting this, I don't know what, say, this is a fire-ish eagle coming outside of it. And next feature that they are having is this outpainting. So this is the input video. This is kind of zoomed a bit in, right? We are having a zoomed in of the character. But what if you want a zoom out or a wide angled shot? So as you can see, the background, these particular portions, has been generated by outpainting, which helps in like fitting any screen size, even if you want to expand it. And next, adding an object. So this is the empty video, and if you want to add an object, it has, this is crazy, like how many features that they have shipped like in VEO 2 itself. And next is going to be removing the object. Seamlessly we can remove unwanted object. This particular portion has been removed. And character controls. And finally, someone has got it into a video generator itself, because many people were actually creating deep fakes using this, but Google has literally like got it into VEO 2 itself. As you can see, the input video, the image, and we could literally use that particular image to get the expressions, and that looks super, super realistic. So that's about VEO 2. And the only thing that people are like kind of negative about VEO 3, it's they say it's so expensive. Like here, as you can see, right, their prices are like quite insane. I guess Google comes up with a way to reduce the prices, but apart from that, they have literally like crushed every single video generation out there. Like they were crushing with their models, like the 2.5 Pro series models, and they gave the Firebase, and now they are like entering the image generation as well as the video generation. They have only entered, but they are literally taking it to the next level, setting up a benchmark. So amazing work by them, and do let me know your opinion in the comments. That's the video, guys. Check the playlist of my channel, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.